Hey everybody, Cypher Boy here with another episode of The Walking Dead No Man's Land. This one is episode 4. I'm doing the voiceover at the moment, and luckily for me, I thought of turning the music off for the episode 5 and doing the voice as I'm playing the game. So this will be, hope, the last voiceover for this one, for this series. From now on, I can just do it during real time. Anyways, I'm in the camp right now. And let's see what I do. because I don't remember. I kind of noticed everything I played for October so far is a zombie game. I'm not surprised because that's the favorite kind of story of mine, along with the favorite movies. So I guess this Halloween is going to be full of zombies, which is pretty fun. I'm actually working on a zombie novel at the moment, so I got 2 chapters in my final draft finished and done, and those are completely done now. Hopefully that'll be out by the 10th of next month. If not, it'll be the 25th. Hopefully I can stay on the schedule, so I'm doing pretty well. I've gotten 2 chapters done just today alone, and then I plan on doing another chapter after I do the voiceover here. Anyways, as you can see, I'm still in the camp. I think Daryl is in training right now, and let's see, trying to make sense of what I'm seeing. It's been a few days since I've played this episode. Something about D block, and for Daryl, I replaced him with Michelle. She has a gun with her. So I think this, okay, this one you have to move the items before you can go after walkers. I was thinking it was one where you can stab through the fence and get them that way, but I guess not. I need to make sure I've got the highest level equipment on my characters the next time I play, to make sure this part is making battles are easier. It's down there on the zone. Is this one of the battles where they got overwhelmed? Because I don't think I could have been, and I see the walkers coming up behind them. 3 of them at least. So, gotta keep that in mind. I don't know how she did the body shot at this today. It's obvious that she has really bad aim or something. And with this, at that particular range, we can do the headshot. Yeah, anyways, I bought this. 6 programs open right now. I'm doing a mix of writing and mixing and voiceover for the videos. I'm trying to keep to a schedule. I got this cool productivity thing called To-Do List, like all one word. It's a computer app. I got Windows, so these are on some kind of website where you can get them. But so far I'm loving it, because you can have the main task and then subtasks below that. And as you complete them, it'll have your main task go up in percentage of completion, so, and you can do, what's it called, like, recurring things. So I have a Patreon, so that helps with my Patreon being able to do the things every like monthly to make sure I get everything out and scheduled and everything that I need to do. So back to the game, we have a couple walkers here that are seen. And my people had to go through and gather the supplies. Now they can move over to the exit and get rid of that last walker there. Nice job, Ricardo. So now I just gotta get Michelle and Ricardo onto their things, and then we want that one. Heavy injury, so Glenn and Michelle, or all three of them actually, are going to be in the medical tent, which is really annoying. Only 3-star type there. Really annoying because they only do one character at a time with the healing, and it looks like Daryl is still... Is he in there, or is he in the med... No, he's in training, never mind. But the other three are in the medical tent. I'm just glad your characters don't get killed permanently, so they just go through and as long as they don't get knocked out, then you don't lose. So, but if they do, you have to take them back and you lose that particular battle. I see here I'm still waiting for the level 6 so I can upgrade the little RV thing up there, the council thing. Got the little pumpkins there for Halloween, the little 3D effects I have on my machine. Sometimes I do bats. I try to remember to put them somewhere in the video, like as a little thing to look out for. Just adds a little bit to the interactive portion. Kind of like Where's Waddle, like, hey, there's the bats, or there, hey, there's the pumpkins, you know? Sure what the 1 minute thing over there is. That's the new building that's being built. Forgot about that already. So do I train them or do, yeah, he's getting trained. At one point I did switch out the weapons and armor and stuff, I believe. The blocks up ahead, fellas. So those are all being healed, so I need to choose new people. So as usual, I go with the one of each three types of ranges, like the blunt weapons, the stabbing weapons, and the ranged ones like crossbows and guns and stuff. Okay, this is one where they can get rid of the walkers through the fence, so that helps it give you an easier time to be able to get them. As many walkers as I can, because each one you kill are more experience points for your characters. Otherwise, if it seems too difficult to do, I just run away if I'm able to. Sometimes I'm not able to, so I end up losing. This one might be one of the ones I did miss on. I don't remember though. It was either this one or the next episode. I gotta move the recording thing out of the way so I can see what's going on the screen. I was covering that part of it where the characters were. Okay, so Ryan is trying to get the gate open, so it's up to Daryl and Joel to get rid of the walkers here. So that was a good idea on my part, because I got the black weapon guy to do it, and if I had gotten the other ones to do it, things would have been a whole lot. Sorry, I can't talk. Super thirsty right now, but it would have been a whole lot more difficult to do. And to think I've got 45 videos left to do voiceovers for. I definitely have enough for the month of October, maybe more for, not 45, it's 24, my mistake, but I have maybe half of November. Those videos are already completed and stored on my computer, so I can upload those starting the end of October. Anyways, it looks like they have a difficult time with the walkers here being all grabby and everything. Daryl, you see there, he's fighting off one now. So Brian has to go and save one of these two. Heavy injuries, but no one died, so that's always a good thing. And all of these characters are still waiting in line to get healed. So in the meantime, I just sit around here and get rid of these walkers here around the camp and figure out other stuff to do.
Thank you.